Your answer to who Jesus is will not only direct your relationship with Jesus, it will ultimately direct your eternity. How you answer this question will ultimately direct your eternity, and especially what you do with your answer. Not, you know, I'm trying to be soft, but not just, yeah, no, I no, they told me I had to say he was God, so I said it. But, you know, who was it? Augustine, I think, said, you know, your actions speak so loud I can't hear a word you're saying. And so it's not just verbal acquiescence, but how do you answer this question with your life? Fortunately, Peter had heard what the world said about Jesus, but it had not influenced him. The world didn't influence Simon Peter. Jesus said, "Who do you say I am?" Simon Peter answered, Matthew 16:16. Simon Peter answered, "You are the Messiah, Mashiach. You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." Messiah, Hebrew, Christ, Greek, are not Jesus' last names, neither of them. They are both titles. They both mean basically the same thing. The anointed one who has come from God to save. That's Messiah, that's Christ. So Peter says to Jesus, "You are the anointed one who has come from God with salvation. You are the Messiah." And then he adds, "You are the Son of the living God," which is why I really like Matthew's source, Matthew's take on this. He says, "You are the Son of the living God." The Son of God does not mean that Jesus was birthed by God. It's a phrase that says literally has come forth from God, but not in that creation sort of way, but expressed out of God. And so Son of God is this title of deity in humanity, right? He's come forth from God in human form. So Peter's response is, "You're the anointed one come from God to save, and you are God clothed in human form." Guys, listen to me, please. Who we believe Jesus is truly, and what authority we believe he has in our lives, will determine everything about our relationship with him. If we are flippant, superficial, casual in our relationship with Jesus, it might be because we don't really understand the authority that he has. We don't understand who he is. We see him as serving us, which is just the weirdest thing in the world when you read the Bible. We see him not with this eternal authority over all of creation. And if we don't see him as that, if we make the mistake, worst case, of seeing him as a good teacher, here's what happens. We will mix his teaching with other people's teaching.